Navakrishna Valley School, जिथे आम्ही आपल्या मुलांना कलात्मक भविष्याकडे नेतो. जिथे आम्ही आपल्या मुलांना प्रेमळ व्यक्तित्वाची जाणीव करून देतो.
मी केमिस्ट्री मध्ये नोबेल प्राइज जिंकणार.
मी बनणार चित्रकार.
मीच आहे जगाचा बेस्ट फुटबॉलर.
मी बनणार आहे IAS ऑफिसर.
मी इंडियन आर्मीत जाणार.
मी होणार भारताची प्राइम मिनिस्टर.
जिथे त्यांच्यातील दडलेले कौशल्य बाहेर आणले जाते.
मला भारतासाठी ऑलिम्पिक गोल्ड जिंकायचे.
जिथे जागतिक ध्येय गाठण्यासाठी आत्मविश्वास दिला जातो. पदार्पण करीत आहे आपल्या रौप्य महोत्सवी 25व्या वर्षा. या आजच आपल्या परिवारात सामील व्हा.
खास मेडिकल आणि IIT स्वतंत्र असणारी महाराष्ट्रातील पहिली शाळा म्हणजे नवकृष्णा व्हॅली गुरुकुल. 8वी, 9वी आणि 10वी ला प्रवेश घेतल्यानंतर पहिल्या दिवसापासूनच तयारी सुरू करा.
शिवाय नीट आणि JEE ऍडव्हान्स क्रॅक करण्याची सुवर्ण संधी असल्याने आजच 11वी आणि 12वी साठीही त्वरित प्रवेश निश्चित करा. वसतिगृहाची सुविधाही उपलब्ध. नवकृष्णा व्हॅली गुरुकुल सांगली.
संपर्क 985-986-3838. www.suraj foundation.org.in.
Good morning, all. Myself, Dr. Sandeep, Associate Professor in Biochemistry, working in Government Medical College, Meerut. I am here to just explain the examiner's view as per the NEET UG is concerned. What are the dimensions? What are the approach of an examiner while setting the paper? Before proceeding with it, let me thanks to Mr. Praveen sir, Praveen Munkar sir, Mr. N.G. Kamas sir for giving me this opportunity and sharing the platform with them just to make it easy the approach towards the biology as well as the NEET UG is concerned. Usually this is a journey of 700 days when the student completes his 10th standard, and the moment they enter into the 11th standard they just dream of either becoming an IITian or then making a career in health sciences. According to World Economic Forum report says that We have just 9 doctors per 10,000 population. Whereas China is concerned, it is just 16. US is 23, and the highest that is Australia, they has some 26 doctors per 10,000 population. This truly saying that we are a shortfall of some 4 lakh more doctors. Hopefully, we must have experienced the situation in pandemic. What are the crises we have faced it? How the education and the health services were diagonally affected. So, by the time you become a medical graduate, you don't have to worry much about entering into the healthcare services or to make a career in the healthcare services. This, the journey starts the moment you enter into the 11th standard. Now, the question is that from where to complete your MBBS? What are the merits? What is the criteria for it? This all we are going to discuss in today's presentation. How many students usually appear? What is the qualifying criteria? How many students they qualify? What is the percentage of that? And what is the reason behind it? That almost 15 to 20 lakh students, they appear per year. And hardly seats are available in thousands. So my question is that, what is the speciality in the students who qualify this NEET UG examination? What is the speciality in that? If you count the number of the students who has secured 95%, 90% 10th standard, but they fail to crack the NEET UG, they fail to secure admission to the medical sciences. That, the entire thing we are going to discuss in today's presentation. So, here I proceed with my presentation. So, just if you see the first slide, it is how to score. There is 340 plus in biology, which is pretty crucial, and I can say that is a milestone. If you crack the 340 plus, the admission to the medical sciences becomes quite easy. Now, in this, if you see the first slide, the number of the candidates registered in 2019 and 2020, and means approximately 15,92,375, and in 2020 it was 15,97,435. Means chances are there that in 2021 the number is liable to increase by 1 lakh or 2 lakh plus. But if you correlate this ratio with increase in the number of medical seats, it's quite less. Means almost 17 to 19 lakh candidates are going to appear in 2021. And those who are there in trial standard or those who are entered in the eleventh standard, almost the number will cross 20 lakh plus. Now out of that 20 lakhs, only few secure the admission to the medical center. This number is quite vast, and this is an all-India examination. This is national level examination. And in this presentation, we are going to discuss what are the approaches, what is the mindset of an examiner. When they set a paper, see, just try to understand one thing. The question is set for just to see that the student should not be able to crack it that easily, because it is meant to set in such a way that the student should get quite confused, they should not be able to crack. It is not just a merit deciding one. Their approach, their frame is just to see that the student should get confused. So number of the candidates present, if you see that, round about less as compared to total number of registered. And then again the criteria is there about the male and female. Now if we go for the second slide, see. Now the same number again comes. Means qualified, out of the 15,97,435 qualified students, there are just 7,71,000, means almost 45%. This is 45%, not more than that. This is the third slide. According to state-wise, we have frame date, number of registered candidate, number of the candidate appeared, number of the qualified candidates, and percentage of qualified candidates. If you see, Delhi 75.49 and Chandigarh is 75.64. But when it comes to Maharashtra, it is just 40.94 and just higher than the Nagaland, that is 40.5. So now here I would like to discuss why this ratio is less. Chandigarh is too small. Geographical wise, Delhi and Chandigarh is too small. Now what went wrong with the Maharashtra? Why Maharashtra students are unable to approach this? If you see, the total number of students appearing from the Maharashtra means it is 2,27,659 out of that's 40% able to qualify. It doesn't mean that they have gotten admission to the medical services. It is just unqualified. Means qualified candidates are different and securing admission candidates are different. Means in Maharashtra, if you see, the rural population is quite high as compared to the metro. The exposure to the metro students is quite high as compared to the rural population. Now, what I have seen, because in Maharashtra we have the schools of three boards, that is state board, CBSE board and ICSE board. The qualifying criteria, qualifying ratio, qualifying percentage is directly, indirectly it is associated with these boards as well. Because as the NEET UG is a national level examination. In further time we are going to discuss that what is the printing style. If we see the printing material of the both the boards, the state board and NCERT or the CBSE board, you will find that the printing pattern is quite different. The content which is printed in the book is quite different. And our reading style, reading habit is also different. Means here we should understand what is printed in the book. You should understand thoroughly like. Means the way of presentation plays a very, very, very crucial role in the way of presentation. The content which is printed in the book, the statement which is highlighted, the statement which is printed in the bold format, the statement which is printed in the box. So we should be able to understand the board who has designed the syllabus. We should be able to read what is printed in the board. Now, if you come to this Delhi 75.49 and Chandigarh 75.64, they are the according to the data levels that the number of CBSE school and ICSE school is too high. It doesn't mean that the state board student doesn't crack. They cracked. Because where we see, my experience is that the student who has qualified from the state board, even easily they have qualified for the NEET UG. Now, what is the difference between the student? Now, what I will suggest, and what is the purpose of this student? What I will suggest in this case is that we should be able to understand grammatically how to read the book. No doubt we are dealing with the science, but here the grammar also matters a lot. Now, if you go for the second slide, so these are the type of the questions. Now here actually the purpose starts. The entire syllabus, the 38 topics we have, out of that 22 topics are there in 11th and 16 topics are there in 12th. Now this is how the entire 90 MCQs are distributed. So my dear friend, I need to focus on this much more. This the entire syllabus, the entire content of the book, the entire content of the printing material which is present in the 11th and the 12th standard. It is divided into one word answer, that is quite factual. Then comes to the conceptual question. Then which of the following statement is correct, are correct? Then which of the following statement is wrong, are wrong? Experimental questions, what happens when? And match the following. And diagrammatic question was just asked in 2016 and that too only one. Now, the merit lies in the conceptual question, which is number is quite high, that is 27. And experimental question, that is 7 as per the 2020 is concerned. See, in last year, 2020, the number of math the following questions were quite high. Means, if you are studied thoroughly, you would have understood, then it is easy to crack. the one word answer or example oriented question, this can be cracked by reading the book carefully and underlying the statement. This, if you have read the book for the 5 times, I'll assure you that the 70 question doesn't make any difference. Then you can crack it. There's one word answer, simple one word answer. This is quite factual. Now, conceptual question, correct, wrong, this number is too high. This number is too high. 27, 38. Miss here, which of the following statements is or correct? Here, either the statements are linked with the concept or the statements are linked with the two or more concept. Either the statements are linked with the one or more topics. Either the statements are linked with one or two units. So whenever you read certain concept, you should be able to correlate with the other concept. Now, the pattern has been totally changed. If you see that in 2016, 12 questions were asked, which of the following statements are correct? The same, that is, which of the following statements are wrong? In 2016, it is 11. Means that ratio has been maintained constant. Means anyhow, out of 90 MCQs, some 13 to 15 MCQs and 9 to 12 MCQs will be which of the following statements is or correct or is or wrong. Means when you are reading the book, when you are reading the concept, you should be able to understand, I am reading this concept for just to for one word answer, conception, whether which of the following statements is or correct or is or wrong. And then followed by the experimental questions, this what happens. Means certain, the content of the book, it is placed in such a format in front of you, that is an experimental form. And I feel that for that you need to have a very logical based thinking. Match the following, if the number of the questions related with the match the following, if it is increased, the criteria for scoring good is also, I can say it is directly related with it, directly proportional to this. If more number of the questions in match the following, certainly the marks are going to increase. If you see the next line, do not one word answer what we are discussing. One word answer means what? The process of growth is maximum during. So simple it is. It is one word answer, this kind of question. If you want to crack this kind of question, then you should read the book carefully. Here, the answer there is chapter 15, Plant Growth and Development, page number 243, second para, line 1, 2 and 3. In most system, the initial growth is slow, likely, and it increases rapidly thereafter at an exponential rate, lower exponential rate. Now here, the question is the process of growth is maximum. The word maximum is very important. This maximum, it is non-biological word. It's not at all related with biology. It is a generalized word. Means while reading the statement, because in book it has been mentioned that in most system, that most is also non-biological word, comma, the initial growth is slow, that is lag phase, comma, and it increases rapidly thereafter at an exponential rate, log or exponential rate. Now, the word log or exponential rate is printed in the book. Both the words are printed in the book. But when the examiner has designed the question, the process of growth is maximum during. And the right option is log phase. Means the content in the book includes both the words, that is log and exponential. So while reading, we should be able to click both the keywords, that log and exponential phase. Let's go for the second question. Now, example oriented. Now, which of the following pair is of unicellular algae, is of unicellular. Now, here I would like to suggest you some important tips. If you see the right option, which is printed on the page number 32, first para, line 12 and 13, pluralized in unicellular algae, rich in protein, used as a food supplement even by the space travelers. Option 4, which includes chlorella and spirulina. That spirulina word is not printed in the book. So for this kind of options, we need to increase the power of elimination. Now power of elimination means what? How we study usually, we open the book, we underline the statement, we prepare our notes, we just go for solving the MCQs. Example oriented. What is this example oriented? This is the first unit in 11th standard. In this first unit, there are biological classification, the living world, kingdom plantae, kingdom animalia. These are equal to the first unit. In every para, the last three lines, which includes examples. Now the same examples, other than related one, is printed in your any of the references book. Means while reading this, you should able to click what are the other examples which is printed in the reference book as well. Means chlorella is printed in the book, but spirulina is not printed in the book. But here the pairs are asked. So in other three options, the chlorella is not mentioned. And you should able to click it, the chlorella spirulina, if even if you don't know what spirulina. This is nothing but the power of elimination. This chlorella is mentioned in the book, it is algae rich in the protein and used as food supplement even by the space travelers. Now here, this is the content which is taken from the book. Here, one more question can be designed very easily, that is the food supplement used by the space traveler includes like this. Now, the second statement, blue-green algae such as spirulina and chlorella species are unicellular organisms used for the dietary supplements. So dash is used as dietary supplement. This also can be a well-designed question. So apart from the example which is printed in the NCERT state, you should be able to go through one of the reference manual. This will go for the next. What is this conceptual question? Now here, you should be able to understand the one concept, this structure of DNA. You should be able to understand charge of rule, Watson and Crick model, type of DNA, A, B. So here, in conceptual equation, if the distance between the two consecutive base pair is 0.34 nanometer, the total number of the base pair of the DNA double helix in a typical mammalian cell is 6.6 into 10 to 109 base pairs. It is 10 to 9 base pair. Then the length of the DNA is approximately its length. So length is asked. Means while reading this question, if I am not wrong, it is printed on the page number 96 of the study. The calculation is given. Along with that, the base pair of E. coli is also printed in the book. There is certain comparison. The word E. coli is also printed in the book. This is 12th standard chapter 6, molecular base of inheritance, page number 99, 6.1.2, packaging of DNA helix, first para. Now, distance between two consecutive base pairs is 0.34 nanometer, that is printed as its statement is clear. This is the first statement, it is just an information. And total number of base pairs of the DNA double helix is 6.6 into 10 to 9. Now, upon that, we should able to calculate. So, this is the calculation phase, this is the conceptual question. This kind of questions are set by the examiner who has read the entire para and designed in such a way that the information which is written in the book, it has elaborated, it has changed its frame, and the angle of the question is changed and it is asked in that way. So while reading, we should do certain calculations as well by which you should be able to crack this kind of question. If you go for the second MCQ, the second time, choose the correct statement or choose the wrong statement like this. Identify the correct statement. Now this pattern has been increased and this is your merit deciding. Which of the following statement is are correct? If you turn the pages of the question paper of last 2 years, 3 years or 4 years, you will find that which of the following statement is are correct. Here it is just one statement. But chances are there that in coming years, 5 to 6 statements will be given out of that. 2 are correct, 3 are correct, they will identify. The last to identify that. So, identify the correct statement with regard to G1 phase, gap 1 of interface. This for that again we need to understand what is my interface. All the four options. So, this statement is printed in the book as it is. The cell is metabolically active, comma, but grows, but does not replicate its DNA. Chapter 10, cell cycle and cell division, page number 163, 4th para, line 234. During G1 phase of the cell, is metabolically active and continuously grow but does not replicate its DNA. Because the word which is printed in the next statement which is there, that is the synthesis of DNA takes place in the S phase of the cell cycle. Means while reading, you should able to understand what is the purpose. Whether I am reading for the factual type of question, whether I am reading for the conceptual type of question, whether I am reading for the experimental type of question. Means once if you go through the para, you should be able to identify which statement is more important and for what type of questions. Whether for one word, it is simple reading. For one word special, the statements are taken directly from the book. But when it comes to that, to choose the correct statement, here your talent, your logic has to be applied. Means choose the correct and choose the wrong. This is going to be what I can say crucial as per the 90 MCQs are concerned. Now let's go for the second type of the question, that is choose the incorrect or the wrong question. Identify the wrong statement. With reference to the gene I and that controls the ABO blood group. ABO blood group is printed in the book. We can understand that inheritance pattern. And here, the wrong statement is asked. Means almost 9 to 12 MCQs where the question reflects the wrong statement. Out of that 4, 1 is wrong, 3 are right. And they are close enough. And only here, one word that is going to decide whether you are going to crack that MCQ or not. The gene I has 3 alleles. A person will have only 2 of the 3 alleles. When A and B are present together, they express the same type of sugar. And allele I does not produce any sugar. When IA and IB are present together, they express the same type of sugar. Option is they express the same. This is wrong. Because if you see the 12th standard book, Principle of Inheritance and Variation, page number 77, codominance, first part, line 5 to 11. It is controlled by gene I. The gene, this is, as it is, this, the entire para is taken, it is split into the 4 different statements. While the allele I does not produce any sugar, and the wrong that expresses the same type of sugar, does not produce and same type of sugar. The sugar word has been kept as it is, but they express same type and does not produce any sugar. Because humans are diploid organism, each person can. So which of the following statement is wrong? Means again here I would like to emphasize on my statement. When you are reading to a certain paragraph, you are going to read it for the 4 basic purposes. So what is that 4 basic purpose? First reading is for factual. Second reading, that is conceptual. Third reading, that is which of the following statement is correct. Even you have to design your own statements. Fourth, that is which of the following statement is wrong. This we have to design. This for that we should be able to understand which is the key word in it. Okay, we'll go for the next step. Experimental question. So if the head of the cockroach is removed, it may live for a few days because it can be asked for associated reason as well. But still now, this type is not at all introduced. The head holds a small portion of a nervous system while the rest is situated along the ventral part of the body. The statement is as it is printed in the book. It can be converted into associated reason. But still then, we don't have that type or that pattern. So, this is an experimental question. What happens next? Basically, this kind of questions are associated with environmental, human physiology. Or, if you see the biotechnology principles and applications, and that plasmids are there, and different genes, what happens next? This kind of question can be related with the lac operon as well. What happens in case of promoter gene, regulator gene? Means, while reading what I said earlier, that you should be able to click it. For what is the purpose, that whether I am reading for the factual type, whether I am reading for the conceptual, whether I am reading for the right option or the wrong option, and beyond that, can you be able to design the experimental question from the given content? So this is the experimental question. We will go for the second slide. Match the following. This is going to give you a good number in the exam. Match the following. The concern essential element and then the functions. Certainly this is going to help you to make the paper easy, because last year some 17 MCQs, and usually the student doesn't go wrong in this. Out of that 4 options, even if you know it 2, you can identify or isolate or eliminate which is the right option. So I personally feel that this is going to boost your confidence while solving the paper. we'll go for the next. This is the same that the answer, it is explanation, which is there. Now, diagram oriented question. A diagram oriented question which only one was asked. Now, here, it is diagram oriented. Okay, it is diagram. Even it can be converted into statistical form, the diagram which is printed in the book. But it is converted to statistical form. Now, here, if you see the reaction and the energy, potential energy, substrate level, product A and B, this, while reading that concept, you should be able to visualize the diagram also. Whether the content correlates with the diagram, means don't read only the content, we should be able to correlate with the diagram as well. Any diagram, it may be structure of heart, it may be DNA replication, it may be the diagrams which are printed in the environment, you should be able to correlate all this. So which of the following describes the given graph correctly? This is related to biomolecule topics. The endothermic reaction with energy A is absence of B. Means this is all related with catalyst. So while reading this kind of content which is next to the diagram, we should be able to correlate and see that you should take a pause while reading this kind of content. At the same time, just see that the very carefully the direction of arrows. See that what is printed in the X axis and Y axis. See the gap between these two lines, and then we should go for the content. Go to the next one. Now, this is an 11th standard book. This I personally feel that the NCERT book is the Bible for this, going through this NEET-UG, where the students usually fail to understand. What is mean by study exactly? Study means what? This question is raised by many students to the teachers, students to the teachers and vice versa. What is exactly studying? Reading the book is called a study. Analyzing the content which is printed in the book is called a study. Or just solving any reference manual is called a study. Or giving the test is called a study. Or scoring very high or qualitative marks in one topic is called a study. How are you going to define study? My dear friends, when it comes to biology, where 38 topics are there, all are interrelated. Hardly few MCQs are asked thoroughly, which is restricted to particular topic or particular concept. That is that too factual. Everything is integrated. Everything is integrated. But we should be able to click it. Means the moment you enter in the 11th standard, you get this book in your hand. But I personally suggest you that for the students who are there in 11th standard, they should buy both the books, 11th as well as 12th, because the content which is printed in the 11th standard book, the same content or carry forward content is present in the 12th standard. If you see the content of this book, this is the first. Now here we are going to discuss how we are going to deal with unit 1, unit 2 till unit 10. What is the specialty of this? Diversity in the living world, which includes four topics: are living world, biological classification, plant kingdom, and animal kingdom. This is an example-oriented unit, feature-oriented unit. Every third line has its own importance and is correlated with the first line. If the book is there with you, if you see, the content is not heavy. It is thoroughly factual. Means there are very less chances that the experimental question is liable to ask on this unit. But chances are there, factual, and which of the following statement is are correct. And example oriented questions are asked on this unit. Simple classification. Now when it comes to plant kingdom and animal kingdom, permutation combinations of MCQ can be very well set with respect to plant kingdom and animal kingdom. Now when you are reading this topic, see that you are reading it for the factual and conceptual rather than the experimental. The number of examples which are printed in these four topics, that is diversity in the living world, that examples, if you are thorough with that examples, certainly it is very easy to dominate this unit. So you are going to study this unit for the sake of features, properties, factual points, and example oriented. So this is very difficult for recollecting. So I personally feel that you need to by heart, you need to solve multiple questions on this. Second unit is structural organization of the plant and animal, which includes morphology of flowering plant, anatomy of the flowering plant, and structural organization animal. Now this unit, you are going to read it for diagram, for example, for features, for comparison. This, for example, what I have noticed, free central type of presentation which is printed in the book, an example is printed on the next page. When the student turns the page, very less remains in the retina of the eye and in the cerebral cortex. Statement is there in the early, on the earlier page. An example is printed on the next page. Here we switch over. So example oriented, feature, comparison. So this entire second unit is just made for the factual and conception. Very less experimental questions. Thorough example. Now here while dealing with this example, again you should go to the first unit where you should be able to correlate with that example. So the examples which is printed in the structural organization of plant and animal and the examples which are printed in the first unit, you should be able to correlate with it. Then only the pair of examples or number of examples or number of animals or number of plants which show a following character, which show particular features, is liable to understand, to interpret, and then to correct the deficit. The third unit is structure and function. Now this is a unit which is a typical biological unit, I can say, because the biology starts with the cell is the unit of life. Biomolecules, cell cycle and cell division, means cellular. This entire unit is integrated. In the chapter 8, they are mentioned about the mitochondria. Their importance will be there in the biomolecules. Their high significance value is present in the cell cycle and cell division. Now here, cell cycle and cell division, experimental questions are liable to ask. In biomolecules, enzyme parameterization. What happens when these kind of questions are liable to ask? Which of the following statement is are correct, is are wrong, liable to ask? Means here the examples are less. And experimental questions, wrong statement, right statement, are more. And when it comes to the cell unit of life, functional approach is mentioned. Means function of lysosome, function of ribosome, function of mitochondria, structure of cell membrane, structure of nuclear membrane. These kind of questions are asked. Means when you are reading the chapter 8, the cell unit of life, you should read it for the function and properties. When you are reading for the biomolecules, your approach should be very precise, experimental based, structure. When you are reading the cell cycle and cell division, here you should be able to correlate the cell division, type of cell division with the prokaryotic, eukaryotic, human being, and experimental questions. Means on the basis of the rate of cell division, kind of MCQs are set on this. Fourth unit, there is plant physiology. This has five topics: there's transport in plant, mineral nutrition, photosynthesis in higher plant, respiration plant, and plant growth and development. So we need to magnify this. Very bulky unit. And no one likes to study this transport in plant, mineral nutrition. I don't know the reason behind it, but the student often shows a negative facial expression when it comes to this transport in plant and mineral nutrition. Content is quite heavy, quite bulky. And every statement has its own importance and quite confusing. When it comes to photosynthesis and respiration, these two topics are correlated. Here you need to understand what is chemistry in it. If you have knowledge of chemistry, then these two topics are quite easy. I'll give this one example. Glyceraldehyde is considered to be a reference carbohydrate. The statement is there in chemistry book. And same kind of statement is present in biomolecules. And that structure of glyceraldehyde, the property of glyceraldehyde, How it is formed, that it is printed in respiration of the plants. So, one more example which is printed is fructose 1,6 bisphosphate. In biology, it is mentioned that fructose 1,6 diphosphate. Here we should understand little chemistry. Certain enzymes, reversible, irreversible. Total number of ATP which are produced means calculation based. This is about calculation based. Means features and calculation based. Cycles, identify the correct sequence. These kind of questions are there. So when we are reading this topic, that is photosynthesis and respiration, both are what means perfectly related, because the content that malic acid, oxalic acetic acid, it is present in respiration, it is present in photosynthesis, C3 pathway, C4 pathway, citric acid cycle. So entire, when you are reading this photosynthesis and respiration, you should read together. These are highly correlated with each other. Then comes to the plant growth and development. This is one para which is printed in this topic, that is differentiation, de-differentiation, re-differentiation. While reading this, we should be very much careful about the non-biological ones. Go for the next unit. This is what the students usually like to understand, to study, to have a talk on this topic. Digestion, absorption, breathing and exchange of gases. This is 7 topics. Students feel that if you know the 7 topics, means you can dominate the biology. Nothing like that. My dear friends, it's not only human physiology. It includes other 9 units as well. Whenever the student sits for studies, he just try to focus on these 7 topics. Breathing and exchange of gases, body fluids, excretory products. Because ultimately, it is related with the human physiology, human body, and the students are more curious to understand this. So they will prefer to focus on this. They will score very qualitative and good marks as per the test related with the human physiology is concerned. But still then, what I will suggest to you is this. The 7 topics, the last part of the 7 topics is very, very, very important, which includes regulation. Regulation of breathing, regulation of circulation, that is locomotion and movement, neural coordination, means conduction of nerve impulse, chemical coordination, means when you are reading that topic, the last 2 pages are very important. So take a pause, study differently these 2 pages. Because this entire process of human physiology is correlated with the brain, so certainly directly, indirectly, it has some association with the neural coordination. It is easy to understand. But when it comes to experimental question, but when it comes to conceptual question, when it comes to right and wrong question, then we fail to understand. If you go for the 6th unit, the 6th unit which is printed in the first standard book, is, if you go for the 2nd slide, this is third standard book. Next slide, this is 6th unit. There is reproduction organism, example oriented. Again, this is example oriented. So reproduction in organism, kingdom plantae, the living world unit, these are correlated. Here the properties, features, examples. Means reproduction organism has to be correlated with the kingdom plantae, has to be correlated with the living world. When you read, try to see, try to turn the pages which is printed in the 11th standard book. Sexual reproduction angiosperm. This is related with the cell division. Means number of mitosis, number of meiosis, this kind of words will appear while solving the MCQ. Means again you have to go back to the 11th standard. Human reproduction, you have to correlate with the control chemical coordination, means hormone related. Reproductive health, it is related with the techniques, that is about the contraception. So this topic, apart from reading what is printed in the book, we should be able to understand how it is correlated with the other topics. Over the 7th unit. This is the unit where the student doesn't like to go with it. Genetics and evolution. Most confusing. Means out of these 10 units, unit 1 and unit 7 and last unit, that is 10th, this is going to decide your merit. Unit 1, that is living world life. Unit 7 is this, genetics and evolution. Means genetic and evolution, what I feel regarding it, the teacher should be that strong enough to make this genetics and evolution highly easy and absorbable. teaching the content which is printed in the book is very much easy. Rather than explaining its application. Mendel, the principle of inheritance and variation, molecular basis of inheritance. And this chapter 7, there is evolution. This is my past experience here that the student doesn't like this topic, that is evolution. Because there are two charts which are printed with respect to botany and zoology. To understand that chart, it takes weeks to have a high control on it. Because multiple statements which can be designed on that. Human evolution, evolution of the plants, evolution in other animals, evolution of reptiles, eels, mammals. So it has to be coordinated along with the errors. So suppose if your friend is studying evolution and even you are studying evolution, at the same time, I personally think that you people should have a discussion on this. Because more and more discussion will help and to regain the confidence in the topic evolution. Means almost 7 pages, out of the 7 pages, one MCQ is set. This is the kind of ratio I can say. That also we are going to discuss in coming slides. If you go for the unit 8, biology and human welfare, again, example oriented, every single statement is highly important. And chances are there that experimental questions are liable to say. Microbes in human welfare, again, you have to correlate this topic with the first unit. Strategy for enhancement of the food production, techniques, human health and disease, MCQ based, that is factual as well as match the followings. So every topic has its own importance and own content, by which that content appeals to the examiner to design a particular type of MCQs. Go for the unit 9, biotechnology, principle and process and its application, integrated it has been placed. Most toughest one. Because if you see the printing style of this NCERT, you'll find that monotonously it is printed. Hardly one or two words or one or two statements is highlighted in the book. That retracts a particular student from reading that continuously. So biotechnology principles and process, you should read from the state book, from the NCERT, from the reference manual. Application, I feel that compared to the principle and process, application is quite easy. Here, different type of techniques like electrophoresis, chromatography, HPLC, this kind of techniques are also mentioned in the book. Beyond that, two or more techniques, we should know it. And finally, we come to this 10th unit. Ecology of it. My previous experience is that almost student, this majority of the student, they quit from this kind of biological topic, that ecology, organism and population, ecosystem, biodiversity, conservation and environmental issues. This, out of these four topics, integrated MCQs are set. One or two statements are very important. Means very less is spoken of this unit. Means unit 1, unit 7 and unit 10, this is going to decide your merit. It is not only about the human physiology unit. It is not only about the unit 6. It is about unit 1, unit 7 and unit 10. If you are perfect with this, if you have read that book diagonally, which includes all these 10 units, you should be able to correlate, if you have correlated that concept, then it is easy to crack 250 plus. Now, what is the difference between this 250 and 340? It is entirely your attitude, entirely your reference reading, entirely your understanding subject, entirely it's all about maturity of the subject. So this 10 units, which is printed in the 11th and the 12th standard book, I personally feel that every word in biology is an object and every statement is an MCQ. So while reading, the tip of the pencil should be on the statement. Go for the next slide. Now, in this total topic 38, 11, 500, 12, 500, 22 chapters, 16 chapters, see the pages wise, 343 pages, 286 pages, total 629 pages, means almost 7 pages. From the 7 pages, one word, almost 7 pages, from that 7 pages, one statement, one MCQ is said from the 7 pages. Means 38 topics, 7 pages. After reading that 7 pages, that too thoroughly, that too diagonally, that too every word, every statement, interpretation, then you are eligible to crack only one MCQ. So understand that. It is just 7 pages for one MCQ. Next. Now, what should be your sequence of study? First and the foremost important thing, that's read the textbook, NCERT, the content which is printed in the book. Then you should be able to underline the important statement. Then try to read the between the lines, means you should be able to interpret what the author has printed in the book, means interpretation of the statement. Then correlate the concept with the other linked topics. Now try to go for the previous equation and then solve the MCQs. What we do right now, we just superficially read the book and then we go for the MCQs only. But the sequence is that you should read the NCERT book carefully, underline the statement, whatever you feel important that. Try to read the between the lines, means you should able to identify the missing statement, missing word between the lines, interpret the statement, correlate with the other topics, relate with the MCQ of the previous year, and then go for the MCQ solving. Next. Now, here, this is a slide. One asked me about this. Sir, how to crack this? See, animal kingdom and locomotion movement, how these call this two topics, how they are correlated. Nidarian exhibit two basic forms called polyp and medusa. The former is sessile and cylindrical form like hydra. And in locomotion and movement topic, hydra can use this tentacle for capturing its prey and also use them for locomotion. Means in animal kingdom, it is mentioned as sessile. And in locomotion and movement, it is mentioned that it is also use them for locomotion. Here the key words are former is sessile and hydra can use. The can is the most important word. Can use this tentacle for capturing its prey and also use them for locomotion. Also use means can and also. You should be able to correlate this. So this is the classic example, just as we have very limited time. So, this is a classic example where the two topics are correlated. Now, identify the set of the animal which are sessile. Where you are going to place the hydra? Because in animal kingdom says that it is a sessile. In locomotion moment, it is clearly mentioned that it can use tentacle for capturing prey and also use, can as well as also use them for locomotion. But still then, it is placed under, that is sessile. So, identify the group of the animals are sessile, so we should be able to click it. What is exactly asked and how the two topics are correlated. Next slide. Now, the same error, locomotion and movement, which is taken from this two pages. Next slide. Now, how an examiner reads this para? Almost all enzymes are protein. Why this almost word is present? Why it has been printed? Why not that all enzymes are protein? No. Almost all enzymes. So here the keyword is almost. You should be able to click in that word. Just don't go on reading. What I say is that non-biological words are very important in biology. There are some nucleic acids that behave like an enzyme. There are some that word not all nucleic acid. Here which of the following statement is are correct? Chances are there that there are all nucleic acids or all nucleic acids that behave like an enzyme. No. Some is the keyword. They also called as ribozymes. So in this manner, we should able to read this para. After reading every statement, we should able to interpret what the author exactly wants to say. Next. Now this is the machinery and the enzyme, the second para. In living cells such as E. coli, the process of replication requires a set of catalysts. The main enzyme is referred as DNA-dependent DNA polymerase, since it is used as the DNA template to catalyze the polymerization of deoxynucleotide. Here the deoxynucleotide instead of deoxynucleoside will change the entire meaning of this para. Now, these enzymes are highly efficient enzymes and they have to catalyze the polymerization of large number of nucleotide in very short time. Here one example which is printed, the E. coli that has only 4.6 into 10 to 6 this pair. Now here in bracket, compared it with human whose diploid content is 6.6 into 10 to 9 base pair. E. coli 4.6 into 10 to 6. In human diploid content is 6.6 into 10 to 9. Bracket close, complete the process of replication within 18 minutes. That means the average rate of polymerization has to be approximately 2000 base pair per second. On this one MCQ can be set calculation based. Means while reading this, you should do a multiple calculations. Means you should take a typical, a very big pause. You should change the number. You should do your calculations. Then you should go. Just don't read to complete the topic. If you see, deoxyribonucleoside triphosphate serves a dual purpose. In addition to acting as a substrate, they provide energy for the polymerization reaction. Deoxyribonucleoside, here the deoxyribonucleotide will change the entire meaning. That is not at all magnified. If you see the content which is printed in the book, it is simple and monotonous. So straightforward it has been mentioned. We should be able to take a pause after reading every three statements. This is going to help you to understand the subject better. Next. Now, non-biological word plays very crucial role in biology. This is, I repeatedly say to everyone, if you understand what is non-biological words, then you will understand the entire biology. Be careful while reading the word almost, slightly, can, may, similarly, broadly, whereas, on the other hand, which can be commonly, another most important and minimum. These are the words where you have to take one. You have to understand what the statement exactly means. And all and none are usually not applicable to the biology. The last point, don't forget to read summary. The first page of every topic is also crucial, and the last page of every topic is also crucial. When we go on reading continuously, when we approach to the last two pages, we try to retract from that topic, we try to get out of that reading mindset. But when it comes to the last page, I personally recommend you to don't forget to read the summary. Summary also has a very important statement, which is printed in a very different format. Over this next slide. Now, importance of chemistry in biology. There are four topics. This is minimum topics. Such as biomolecule, typical chemistry, photosynthesis. All kind of acids are printed in this photosynthesis. Respiration, molecular base of inheritance, like nucleotide, nucleosides, enzymes. So, importance of chemistry in biology is while reading these four topics, you should be well acquainted with some chemistry concept. You should have a good hold on the chemistry. And then it is assured that you will understand the subject or the topic which includes biomolecule, photosynthesis, respiration, and molecular base of inheritance. Let's go for the second. Now here, see what I was trying to explain, the first page. Ernest Mayr, the Harvard University evolutionary biologist, who has been called as Darwin of the 20th century. This question was asked. But usually students fail to go through this content. The Darwin of the 20th century, the name is mentioned already of a different scientist, and we are going to identify the right option. Rest of the matter, of course, every content or every word in the biology book has its own importance. Every statement is an MCQ. Every word is an option. So don't forget to read the introduction, some short biography of the scientist, and the last page which includes summary. So here I really thank you for patient listening. And if there is any doubt or query related, you can post it. Thank you very much. Thank you.
नवकृष्ण वैली स्कूल, जिथे आम्ही आपल्या मुलांना कलात्मक भविष्याकडे नेतो. जिथे आम्ही आपल्या मुलांना प्रेमळ व्यक्तित्वाची जाणीव करून देतो.
मी केमिस्ट्री मध्ये नोबेल प्राइज जिंकणार.
मी बनणार चित्रकार.
मीच आहे जगाचा बेस्ट फुटबॉलर.
मी बनणार आहे IAS ऑफिसर.
मी इंडियन आर्मीत जाणार. मी होणार भारताची प्राइम मिनिस्टर.
जिथे त्यांच्यातील दडलेले कौशल्य बाहेर आणले जाते.
मला भारतासाठी ऑलिम्पिक गोल्ड जिंकायचे.
जिथे जागतिक ध्येय गाठण्यासाठी आत्मविश्वास दिला जातो. पदार्पण करीत आहे आपल्या रौप्य महोत्सवी 25व्या वर्षा. या आजच आपल्या परिवारात सामील व्हा.
खास मेडिकल आणि IIT स्वतंत्र असणारी महाराष्ट्रातील पहिली शाळा म्हणजे नवकृष्णा व्हॅली गुरुकुल. 8वी 9वी आणि 10वी ला प्रवेश घेतल्यानंतर पहिल्या दिवसापासूनच तयारी सुरू करा.
शिवाय नीट आणि JEE ऍडव्हान्स क्रॅक करण्याची सुवर्ण संधी असल्याने आजच 11वी आणि 12वी साठीही त्वरित प्रवेश निश्चित करा. वसतिगृहाची सुविधाही उपलब्ध. नवकृष्णा व्हॅली गुरुकुल, सांगली.
संपर्क 985-986-38-38.